بذكر الله ترتاح القلوب وتنزاح المتاعب والكروب.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد في الأولين وفي الآخرين وفي كل وقت وحين وفي الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين، عليه وعلى جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه وأتباعه إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، الإخوة الأخوات، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله جل وعلا، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة. The believers, the best thing to achieve in this life, the servant achieve loving of his Lord, Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To achieve loving for the one who give life and take life. The one who support, the one who help, the one who we should trust and rely on him, Jalla wa Ala. The one who keep care, take care about us, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. The unique God, the only one God, the Creator, Almighty Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. The believers, every believer, every Muslim should work hard to achieve that loving. Mahabba, Mahabbatullahi Jalla wa Ala lil'abd. Loving of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the servant. And to achieve that kind of love, loving of Allah to us, there is processing, there are ways, methods to achieve that loving. The first of these, Tawheedillahi Jalla wa Ala. To have pure monotheism, pure oneness of God, pure إيمان، إيمان بالله الواحد الأحد الفرد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. The unique God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No association with him, any other God, any other love. He's the first love in our life and he's the first priority in our love. This is the short meaning of the word Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar means Allah the first priority in our life. Before everything, Allahu Akbar. Before everything, Allah comes subhanahu wa ta'ala. To achieve faith, strong faith come through loving Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and achieve iman by heart, by tongue, and by acting of the body. By heart, to accept Allah alone as God, as Ilah to the person, and never associate with him, Jalla wa Ala, any other gods or any other loving with him, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. And by tongue, to keep uttering La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. Keep saying that by tongue, that go with the heart and the tongue, and the body act by the meaning of La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, the meaning of true and pure iman and faith in Almighty God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Should accept Allah and know His attributes, learn His qualities of Almighty, the unique God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The believers, among these reasons to achieve loving of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for us to follow the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sunnah of the one who lead us in this life and next life, Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wa sallam. To work, learn the sunnah, and work and make the sunnah in every single part in our life. When we act, when we have business, when we have any project, any business, anything in this life, show it to the Quran and Sunnah al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What goes with the sunnah, approve it and go with it. What it is against sunnah, remove it and avoid it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say in the Holy Quran, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Say, O Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, if you love Allah, then follow me. So Allah will love you and forgive your sins. And Allah is forgiving and merciful, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So whoever follows al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the steps of the sunnah of Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, Allah loves him or her. Very clear. Very clear. Whoever follows the sunnah of Mustafa alayhi salatu wasalam, Allah loves him or her. Because following the steps of the sunnah, that means you love sunnah. You love the person of the sunnah, Mustafa alayhi salatu wasalam, Sayyidina Muhammad. And whoever loves the Rasul and his sunnah, Allah jalla wa ala loves him or her. And you're going to find support from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for everything in our life. You're going to find blessing in actions, blessing in our life among. The believers, among these reasons that bring the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, serving Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala, ibadatul haqq, tabaraka wa ta'ala, worshipping Almighty Allah jalla wa ala. And worshipping come firstly with obligation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala obligate to do in this dunya, in this life. Allah obligate us five, with the shahada to enter Islam, and then salawah, daily five prayers, al-zakah, al-hajj, al-sawm, and then al-hajj. So obligation, first step, obligation, first step, this is show how the person follow the Islam, follow the steps of Islam, follow the steps of Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. In Hadith Qudsi, الرب تبارك وتعالى يقول وما تقرب إلي عبدي بشيء أحب إلي مما افترضته عليه وما يزال عبدي يتقرب إلي بالنوافل حتى أحبه. And the most beloved things with which my servant comes nearer to me, is Allah talking about that, is what I have obligated upon him, al-fara'id. The most thing that Allah loves from us to do and make us close to him, jalla wa ala, al-fara'id. Al-fara'id, obligations, obligation, duties, ibadat over us. And whoever do extra from nawafil, sunan, listen, and my servant keeps on coming closer to me through performing nawafil till I love him. Till I love him. So al-fara'id, achieve close. And nawafil, sunan, achieve loving of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Think about that. As sunan, some of us careless about sunnah. In salah, in fasting, in all activities, sadaqah, Sunan, we should learn about Sunan, because Sunan is the rank of Ihsan, position of Ihsan, the highest position in that religion. Islam, Iman, Ihsan. So doing Sunnah, doing extra activity from what Rasulullah used to do, it make loving of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala achieved. Think about that. And this hadith, authentic narration, come in Bukhari Muslim, mention. And my servant keeps on coming closer to me through performing nawafil till I love him. Hatta uhibbu. Till I love him. Everybody look for that position. Every believer, every Muslim, look for that position. The believers, then the head of these obligations after tawheed, after la ilaha illallah, as-salah. As-salah. And the best thing to do salah on time. Salah on time. Dhuhr on dhuhr. First time of dhuhr. Asr, Maghrib, Isha, Fajr. All that should be on time on the first. That indicate that the servant is sincere servant. Don't sleep while you can do prayer. It's a big problem, a big trouble. When the person is sleep without reason, while he can get up to do Salat al-Fajr on time. Don't sleep till the sun rays and start to get up and make wudu and pray. It's too late for prayer. Still okay, Allah will accept it, but it's not like the one who get up early on time and go to the masjid, the steps of the masjid, every step remove from the sins and elevate rank in Jannah. Allahu Akbar. Think about that. So the best thing to do to make us close to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as-salah. As-salatu ala waqtiha. Prayer on time. Don't collect dhuhr with asr without reason, without excuse. Dhuhr, asr, maghrib, isha at the end of the day without excuse. Only excuse of the person in traveling or sick, or you know the excuse for that. But if there is no excuse and then collect, is a trouble. It's a big trouble. Make the person beyond, back in the line of beloved people to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Think about that. Think about that. Don't be lazy for serving your Lord. The life is short. And we are testing in this life. Think we are in test. Your age, the period of the test. Once death come, the end of test come. And go to correction, your test. Do salah on time, pass. Fasting Ramadan, pass. Zakah, pass. Hajj, pass. Pass to Jannah. If there is issues in the salah, this is what will be asked the first question, Yawm al-Qiyamah. Tawheed in grave. Question about Tawheed in the grave, in Qabr. The angels came and asked the person about your Lord, your Prophet, your Deen in the grave. Yawm al-Qiyamah, the question about A'mal, actions, deeds. And the highest deed we should care about it, which is our Salah. Salah is a connection. Think about that. You have meeting every day, five times with Allah. So if the person love Allah truly, never get away from that, and on time or before even the time, before even the time, because he know, understand that meeting with the King of Kings, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine you have a meeting with the president, with the king. What's gonna happen before that meeting? Weeks, maybe prepare yourself, right? This meeting with Almighty God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why that person care about Salah and the person careless about Salah? The point is Al-Iman, faith. Faith, Al-Iman, strong faith, strong Iman, draw the person to care about his Salah. weak iman make the person careless about salah. Allah. Think about that. What make my faith, my iman is strong? Practice. Dhikr. Knowledge. Ilm. Huh? Get yourself away a little bit from dunya. Understand the nature of dunya. Nature of this life is a test. All of us, believers, non-believers, all humanity in this life as test. لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. To test you with the best good deeds among you. Think about that and carry it as a great advice. Advise myself, advise you to achieve that point. Care about your salah. As-salah, draw the person close to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the person achieve loving of Almighty Allah jalla wa ala. O Allah, gift us your love and everything you love. O Allah, love, let us love Quran, love Sunnah, love Salah, love the Masjid, love everything you love, our Lord. Ameen, Ya Rabbil Alameen. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. أستغفر الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صلي وسلم وزد وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وأتباعه إلى يوم الدين. Believers, before going to the second khutbah, this the class is empty and the masjid here is jammed now, so please move there or forward. Front, move forward, please. Make gap for others who come back. Come forward. جزاكم الله خير. Thank you so much. Or the class is empty. Yes. And it's still in the masjid, mashallah. You can join there, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. The believers, when Allah love His servant, this is a sign now. How I know that Allah love me. How I know that Allah doesn't love me. Or at least, I'm the way that Allah gonna love me. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves a person, His servant uses him or her in service. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves somebody, believers, Muslims, He make that body, that person, love salah, love coming to the masjid, love serving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, love. So loving inside the heart of the believers, of the person, show how the action show how we love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah, that's indication, that's a sign that Allah jalla wa ala love the person. So when Allah loves somebody from His believers, from servants, use him or her in serving, worshipping, and spread acceptance among His creation. Look at that great hadith, authentic narration, Bukhari Muslim. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا أحب الله عبدا نادى جبريل إن الله يحب فلانا فأحبه فيحبه جبريل فينادي جبريل في أهل السماء إن الله يحب فلانا فأحبوه فيحبه أهل السماء ثم يوضع له القبول في الأرض أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. When Allah جل وعلا loves a person, a servant, calls out Gibril and say, I love so and so. Allah called Gibril, the head of angels, the head of angels, Gibril, the one who is responsible for revelation, al-wahy, to all prophets and messengers, Gabriel. Allah said to Gibril, I love so and so, so love him. Then Gabriel loves him, that person. After that, Gibril announces to the inhabitants of the heavens, angels. That Allah loves so and so. So love him. So all the angels love that character, that person. Allahu Akbar. The angels in heavens, billions of billions of angels in heaven. Imagine that. And since this minute, this second, the person will be very famous. Very famous in heavens. When a spirit gets out from the body and go, so they welcome him. Allahu Akbar. Because they used to listen to his Quran, his prayers, his dua, and now the spirit come up to them, to heavens. And they know him well. They know him well. Maybe somebody is unknown, unfamous on earth, but very famous in heavens. And very famous on earth, but unknown in heavens. Allahu Akbar. What the criteria, what the difference? Knowing Almighty Allah Jalla wa Ala. Serving Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Salah on time. Worshipping Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Think about that. Then the angels love him. And then Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala spread acceptance among people, among humanity on earth. The believers, قال ربنا جل وعلا ألا إن أولياء الله لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون الذين آمنوا وكانوا يتقون لهم البشرى في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة لا تبديل لكلمات الله ذلك هو الفوز العظيم. No doubt that the servants of Allah, there will be no fear concerning them. لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزن. No fearing for them. When they get up from the grave, يوم القيامة, all people worry, anxiety, fearing, all humanity. But the servants of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the angels receive them. Don't worry. Calm down. Is your day. Don't worry. So they give them good news, good tidings. While others worry, anxiety and fearing. But the believers received by the angels, calm down, quiet, go here, that place, that. Subhanallah. And processing of Yawm al-Qiyamah will be easy for them. Processing till Jannah. Very, very easy. Very easy. The angels and the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, Sayyidina Muhammad, and the righteous of the Ummah, leaders, scholars, they help all the congregation, all the Ummah, all the nation to pass processing of Yawm al-Qiyamah easily till they go to Jannah. No doubt that the servants of Allah, there will be no fear concerning them, nor will they grieve. Those who believed and were fearing Allah. Look at that. الذين آمنوا وكانوا يتقون. Iman and practice taqwa. The fear from Allah here, no fearing there. Allahu Akbar. Think about that. They care about Allah here, so Allah care about them here and there. Think about that. Youth, young men, Allah bless you all. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Think about that. Taqwa Allah Jalla wa Ala. First. Allah first in our life. Youth, don't deceive by dunya. Don't deceive by your power, your age. Don't deceive by that. Death come to all. Young kids, children, youth, men, women, adult, old. Everybody has a time and should be ready for that time. Everybody. Think about that. I'm reminding myself, waiting for my time. And my brother and sisters, to be ready for your time. By fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, practice taqwa. This is halal, okay. This haram, avoid it. Avoid it. Don't practice haram. Don't practice haram. Haram make Allah angry against us and remove the barakah from our business, barakah from children, barakah from everything in our life. Practice life like non-believers, subhanallah. However, we carry iman and faith and tawheed, but life will be like non-believers. No barakah, subhanallah. Again to the ayah. Those who believed and were fearing Allah, for them are good tidings in the dunya. When they come to the last minute in their life, al-maut, death. Before finish death, this has processing. Processing for death start. The angels of death. The head of them, angel of death, had assistance. They come to the body and take the spirit gradually from the foot, leg, belly, chest, and then we come to here, neck. Now everything unseen become seen. Khalas, last second in the life of the person. Some people see their position in Jannah, so they are very delighted, very happy about that. And there is sign on their faces when they pass away. Others see their position in hellfire, or there is sign about that in their faces. So there is good tidings, great news for them while they are in that second, last second before leaving life to the next life. What the great news about that? Don't worry. This is your day. Look here at the position. This position in Jannah. This is good news from Allah Jalla wa Ala. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Send this message to you. So, no grief, and there is good tidings for them in this dunya and hereafter. Look, two messages come to the believers when they come to the end of their life and when they go there in Akhirah, Yawm al-Qiyamah. No change is there in the words of Allah. This promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one can change the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah never break his promise. Allah never, never, when he promised something, know that gonna happen, subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is what is the great attain in this journey of life. We ask Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the end of the reminder to guide us all. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. We ask Allah Jalla wa Ala to keep us on the guidance in this life and next life. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to light our hearts by the Quran and Sunnah. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. We ask Allah Jalla wa Ala to achieve His love in this life, Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who Allah Jalla wa Ala loves him, love them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide our youth, Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen, our spouses, our families, Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to spread barakah, blessing in your business, in your families, in your life, all, Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina وثبت على الحق أقدامنا وانصرنا على من عادانا يا رب العالمين خذ بنواصينا إليك أخذ الكرام عليك توفنا مسلمين وألحقنا بالصالحين أحسن خلاصنا وأحسن نهايتنا يا رب العالمين اللهم أحسن خلاصنا يا ذا الفضل والمن والجود والكرم والإنعام عاملنا بما أنت أهله ولا تعاملنا بما نحن أهله فنحن أهل التقصير والزلل والخطأ والخطيئة أما أنت يا مولانا أهل التقوى وأهل المغفرة اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت على الحق أقدامنا وانصرنا على من عادانا يا رب العالمين اللهم طهر قلوبنا وزك نفوسنا ورق أرواحنا واجعلها في عليين مع النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين يا رب العالمين نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار يا عزيز ويا غفار كل المستضعفين من المسلمين في كل مكان يا رب العالمين، ولملم شعث هذه الأمة يا أكرم الأكرمين يا رب العالمين. اللهم اشفنا واشف مرضانا وجميع مرضى المسلمين، وارحم موتانا وجميع موتى المسلمين، وارحمنا إذا ما صرنا إليهم يا رب العالمين. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صلي وسلم وزد وبارك على هذا النبي المبارك وعلى آله وأصحابه، آمين يا رب العالمين. وأقم الصلاة.